Damn it. Hey, Bruce. I wasn't expecting you. Thought I'd make it outside the city limits, at least. Clearly, my ride needs a tune-up.
If you wanted to see me, you could have just called.
The chase is so much more fun. But I know you're not here for me, are you? I don't blame you for wanting it back. Although, it only seems fair that I take something from you. You didn't give a second thought when you stole my claw. At least I had the decency to steal from you when you weren't in the next room. Serves me right for leaving you alone.
I don't know what I was thinking, okay? That was wrong.
Well, your hindsight's 20/20. I'm surprised you had a toy like this. No doubt Batman would use it for the good of Gotham, but the less noble options are so much more exciting. Why should I give it back? So much potential. Just imagine what I'd be able to dig my claws into.
A thief of your class doesn't need a device like that. It'd only be a crutch.
Says the man whose belt is an armory. Catch. I know you're just playing into my pride, but you're right. I don't need a crutch. Oh, come on. Don't pretend you're not impressed. As long cons go, this one was a beauty. Getting into Wayne Tech's lab took a lot more than cracking a safe. I had to get close to people. Your friend Harvey. Poor guy just wanted to fall in love so bad. After that, it didn't take very long to get my introduction to his BFF. The great Bruce Wayne. Imagine my surprise when the rich playboy turned out to be Batman. Scourge of Gotham. I was always going to steal from Bruce Wayne. I just never expected he'd be so interesting. As a mark, that is.
You talk a good game, but I don't buy it for a second. You're not that shallow.
You really think you know me that well?
I know that whatever this started as, that's not all it means to you now.
The only thing it means is that I'm very good at my job. I'm getting out of here while the getting's good. Gotham's a house on fire, and I'm not gonna burn with it. If you were smart, you'd get out of here too. This town hates you, hates your entire family. Just leave it all behind. Do something more meaningful with those skills of yours. You don't need the money, but think of the fun.
Gotham needs me. And I won't abandon the people of this city, no matter how they feel about me.
After the way they've treated you, you've got one hell of a thick skin. You're gonna need it. It'll be good to put some distance between us. After all, look at what happened to Harvey. It'd only be a matter of time before I crossed one of your lines. Isn't that right? My copy of the Boy Scout Handbook is out of date. I'm bound to break some rule.
Selina, I would never hurt you.
Bruce, that's really sweet. But it brings us to the root of our problem, doesn't it? You're upset that I'm leaving. What'd you think? That one night of sex meant we were going steady? Is that what you really thought?
Well, maybe it meant nothing to you, but what happened between us meant something to me.
Oh, Bruce. Didn't know you were the sensitive type.
Just stop the show, Selina. Stop pretending nothing matters.
Look, Bruce. I'll admit that what you and I had, it wasn't terrible. But you were just another job. A more intriguing job than I was expecting. But still a job. And that job's done. I'm done with you. It's not complicated. I'm not a good person. I'm certainly no hero, and I don't want to be. I'm a thief. That's all I am. I told you that from the start. I never pretended to be anything else.
Stop. It's not true. I know there's more to you than that. You're just afraid to admit it.
You'd like it if that were true, wouldn't you? Why would you even think that? I've made my feelings pretty clear. Why aren't you listening?
You saved my life. You could have left me to die back in that warehouse, but you didn't. Someone who's only out for herself, who's just a thief, wouldn't do that.
Oh yeah? Who would?
A good person. That's who. A hero.
You know, after I found out you were Batman, I thought nothing else could surprise me. But you just keep on surprising me.
Something to remember me by.
I won't need any help remembering you. Well, it's been fun.
You stay out of trouble, because if I catch you taking what's not yours again, I'll have to stop you.
I look forward to our next dance.
Lucius, I've got the key. Hold on, Alfred's on the line. Hey, Alfred,
Bruce! Lady Arkham! She's here! I tried to keep them out, but...
Alfred? Alfred! Alfred! Lucius, it's Bruce. He's not here. Damn it. I'm going to search for clues.
Just tell me how I can help.
Get over here as fast as you can.
I'm on my way. We're gonna find him, Bruce.
I know. Need to focus. Figure out what happened here. What happened to you, Al? Been completely destroyed. Alfred must have barricaded himself in here. But they got in anyway. Blood pattern looks like it came off a high velocity hit. This pool cue was used as a weapon, swung so hard it broke in half. Alfred used the pool cue as a weapon, broke it across his attacker's head. When that didn't stop him, he used the jagged end to stab him, spraying blood across the pool table. Face was knocked over in the struggle. The fight left nothing untouched. Something big was thrown against this wall. Or someone. Everywhere. What did they do to you, Alfred? a scuff mark.
What could have caused this? Furniture scattered outwards from a single point. No. I don't see a connection here. The poker couldn't have made that crack. Alfred grabbed the fireplace poker to fend off an attacker, but it was knocked away. Lady Arkham must have used the concussion blast from her staff to try and stop Alfred. I know what happened. The Children of Arkham broke in. Alfred barricaded himself inside the parlor. He had just enough time to grab a pool cue as a weapon before Lady Arkham blasted the doors open. He broke it across one of their heads, then stabbed him to get away. Another assailant tackled Alfred, knocking over the vase. Alfred almost escaped, but then Lady Arkham entered the parlor. Used her staff's concussion blast, scattering all the furniture in her path, throwing him against the wall by the fireplace. So Alfred grabs the nearest thing to use as a weapon to defend himself. But Lady Arkham deflected Alfred's attack, causing the poker to fly across the room and lodge into the wall. More blood on the mantle. He smashed his face into it. Wait, that picture doesn't belong there. Lady Arkham wanted me to find this. Alfred. The butler did it. Password reckoning. You have no idea.
Look at what she's doing to him.
All right. Well, then let's get to work.
Alfred keeps adjusting his glasses. The reflection. He's making sure I see the reflection in his glasses. He knows the Bat computer can use multiple reflection angles to recreate the room that he's in. And I can view the virtual image using my cowl.
Good thinking, Alfred.
Damn it. I can't access the news feed. I need to get this working again. Damn it. Still offline. I need to get this working again. Okay, Lucius. Freeze frame on the first signal Alfred gives.
Paint us a picture. Here we go.
Professional grade camera. Probably came from the Gazette's office. He's wounded.
Must be one of the thugs Alfred fought upstairs.
Stairs leading up. Cement walls. We're in a basement. Alfred's trying to look at things that might give us a clue to where he's being held. Okay, looks like we've seen all there is to see in this frame. Let's move on to Alfred's next signal.
You got it.
Rogers Plumbing. A service company for the water heater. I can use their records to find home addresses for their clients.
We're getting closer.
Yeah, but we're not there yet. Doesn't seem to be anything else here.
Let's keep looking.
Nothing else to see here.
Moving on.
A Mason stamp.
Only one Masonic lodge in the city. Gotham City Fraternal Order of Stonemasons.
So the house was built in 1945 by them. That's a big lead. Lady Arkham. Keep searching. Jump to Alfred's next signal.
You got it.
A basement window.
What's that outside?
Give me a second. They're by a bus stop.
There we go.
Okay, I think we have enough to pinpoint a location.
Well, let's hope.
I can get the bus line from this, but no stop number. This will help pinpoint the neighborhood. Filtering for all homes built on that date. These are all the homes serviced by this water heater company on the days and months listed. A corner store. Seems unlikely. Bowling alley. Damn it. Let's keep looking. Not going to believe this.
What is it?
Lady Arkham is back at the Vale House, where she killed her foster parents. According to its records, it has a basement. We know where Alfred is, but I'm without a working bat suit.
Actually,
one of the early prototypes.
It has basic cowl functionality, but outside of that, it doesn't protect much more than your identity, I'm afraid.
Good call. Thank you, Lucius.
It doesn't have all the bells and whistles, but it should still scare the crap out of criminals. This ends tonight. Heading into the basement.
Be careful.
I'm all right.
There's no one here. No Alfred.
Damn it!
There's blood on the walls. I'm going to see what I can find.
Standing by.
This is where they had Alfred. Where they beat him. The blood hasn't congealed yet.
Means we can't be far behind them.
There's a boot print in the blood. Lady Arkham's soldiers dragged him. The trail stops at the wall. Actually, it goes under it.
Sounds like there's more to this basement than it would appear.
Taking a closer look. The wall is just a facade.
Why would the Vales have a false wall in their basement?
Now let's find out where the Vales were hiding. There's a small room. With a hole in the floor. A rope ladder.
Anyone down there would be trapped.
Alfred!
I'm going inside. Killed the Vales.
They abused her.
I'm not saying what she did was right, but... I can't imagine what she went through.
The Vales' foster children may not have been the only ones to suffer here. I followed Alfred's blood into this hole. If he had any opportunity at all, he would have left me a clue. There are drawings. Vicky must have drawn them when she was a prisoner. The chalk here is different, newer. The belt. It's caked in blood. Bloody scratches, fingernails. Someone tried to climb out.
Alfred?
No. Shackles. Blood on them. Old. And new. Vicky did to Alfred what was done to her. Disturbing. Vicky created her here, in this room. This is where Vicky Vale became Lady Arkham. This blood is fresher than the rest. Must be Alfred's.
Alfred's glasses.
one piece apart from the others. Blue. The same color as my tack. Can't be a coincidence. Maybe... figures fleeing from something. Is that Arkham Asylum? Some of the words have been highlighted. She will liberate. Alfred left me another clue. This is what he wanted me to find. To see. The newest chalk. He's added to an old drawing of Arkham Asylum. He drew figures outside the gates, like they're running away. The words highlighted are, she will and liberate.
She will liberate? I don't see what that has to do with Alfred.
Alfred's just along for the ride. She's been using Wayne Enterprises to get access to the buildings with Wayne Tech security systems, including Arkham Asylum. She's going to open the doors, release the inmates, and she took Alfred with her. Call Gordon in the GCPD.
I'm on it.
Lady Arkham won't be expecting us. We'll catch her by surprise.